Good morning. And welcome to this, our celebration of the Holy Mass for the second Sunday of Easter. We begin with our opening hymn, Alleluia, Sing to Jesus.
Alleluia, sing to Jesus, is the scepter, is the throne. Alleluia, is the triumph, is the victory alone. Hark the songs of peaceful Zion, thunder like a mighty flood. Jesus out of every nation has redeemed us by his blood. Alleluia, not as orphans are we left in sorrow now. Alleluia, he is near us, faith believes nor questions how. Though the cloud from sight received him when the 40 days were o'er, shall our hearts forget his promise, I am with you evermore.
Let us begin now with our entrance antiphon. Like newborn children, you should thirst for milk, on which your spirit can grow to strength. Alleluia. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Let us begin, as we always do, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Will the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
My dear friends in Christ, in order for us to celebrate our sacred mystery today, let us first call to mind our sins. In today's gospel, we meet Doubting Thomas. Each of us has something in common with him, because at times we too are troubled by doubts. Instead of denying our doubts, let us bring them to the Lord. In his love for us, the Lord helps us turn our doubts into faith. Lord Jesus, you help us believe that your love for us is unchanging and unfailing. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you help us believe that your forgiveness is all-embracing. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you help us believe in your promise of eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God forgive you your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax hominibus, bone voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratias agimus tibi, propter magnam gloriam tuam, Domine Deus Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Filii Unigenite, Jesu Christe, Domine Deus Agnus Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Quoniam tu solus sanctus, quam ut qui tollis peccata mundi, suscipe deprecationem nostram, qui sedes ad exteram patris, miserere nobis. Quoniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus, Jesu Christe, cum Sancto Spiritu, in gloria Dei Patris. Amen.
now begin the liturgy of the word. Let us pray as Christians thirsting for the risen life. Heavenly Father and God of mercy, we no longer look for Jesus among the dead, for he is alive and has become the Lord of life. From the waters of death you raise us with him and renew your gift of life within us. Increase in our minds and hearts the risen life we share with Christ, and help us grow as your people toward the fullness of eternal life with you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. In our first reading today from the Acts of the Apostles, we learn that early Jerusalem church devoted itself to the teachings of the apostles, the Hebrew Bible, and the way, as Jesus had interpreted it by word and example. Breaking of the bread became the Holy Eucharist in its earliest form. The prayers of participation were like those of the Jewish temple. All things were shared in common for at least some time in the Jerusalem church, not meant to become a universal law for all Christians, but it attested to their fellowship. Hear now these words from Acts. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of bread and to the prayer. Awe came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed together and had all things in common would sell their property and possessions and divide them among each according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals in exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be
to God. Our response today, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. I was hard-pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. In our second reading, taken from the first letter of Peter, it is probably an early sermon given on the occasion of a baptismal ceremony. It relates our rebirth through baptism to the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Christian rebirth from water and the Spirit is a birth to hope, to an imperishable inheritance. It is for all of you who, by the power of God, are safeguarded through faith. Hear now these words from 1 Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, in his great mercy, gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading. It is kept in heaven for you who, by the power of God, are safeguarded through faith to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now, for a little while, you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable, even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. This too is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us stand now as we prepare for the reading of the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Join me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. You believe in me, Thomas, because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are they who have not seen me, yet still believe. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Lord, be my heart, among my lips, and I will proclaim your holy gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading of the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples gathered for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you shall forgive, they are forgiven them, and whose sins you shall retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said in reply, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again inside. This time, Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst, saying, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here, and see my hands, and bring your hand, and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through his belief you may live in his name. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Throughout our lives, it is not uncommon for us to have many doubts. We live in an age where scientific reality is thrust upon us in a daily manner, momentarily changing everything that we believe from one moment to the next. It is not difficult, then, to understand why we should have doubts. It might be said that today there are more skeptics than any other type of individual. And we have good reason to be skeptical, for a lot of false information is presented to us on a regular basis. Our media is full of false information, and it's difficult for us to discern which is true and which is not. We end up having to trust one source or another in order for us to come to some sort of factual understanding of what is occurring in our world. In Jesus' time, the apostles had spent their lives for the 3 years of Jesus' ministry following him, listening to him, seeing his miracles, watching him interact with people, seeing him be the ideal human being, living for the sake of his beliefs. They, in fact, became true believers and followers. And they are called apostles for that reason. We are not called apostles today, but we are called disciples. And disciples means students. Students of the truth, we hope, when in fact we profess the word of God that has been handed down for us for nearly two millennia. And in saying that, we have quite a statement that we've made. For we have not seen Jesus in the flesh. We have not observed his miracles. We have not heard his words. But we read of the accounts of those things in the Holy Scripture. The New Testament is full of Jesus' activities and the apostles presenting those activities to others, notably Paul, who traveled throughout the Mediterranean and spread what is today the basis of the Christian faith. It is said without Paul, chances are there would not be a Christian faith. For his travels were myriad and very in depth, for he founded churches everywhere he went. And then true believers came to accept what he had said, and they too became disciples. We are given understanding of Jesus' ways, the way, as it was called in the early days, simply by reading and listening to the Holy Scripture. We have to believe on faith thereby. It is said that for those who have faith, no proof is necessary. The converse is also true. Those without faith will find no proof sufficient. So a faith is true blessing. And if in fact we have faith in Jesus Christ, then we look forward to our own resurrection from the dead, in our own glorification, in life everlasting. In the meantime, we have to struggle through life. And so there have been many, many theories of life that we have been confronted, or that have been confronted by human beings in the world, not the least of which are those Eastern philosophies that say that life being a journey of one moment to the next, it then repeats and we are reincarnated until we get it right. And so that reincarnation gives us an opportunity to try again. So if you are of that belief system, you are looking forward to a better life in the future after you die. As Christians, we don't have the doctrine of reincarnation, but we do have the doctrine of eternal life, where we will rise again with Christ and be one with him in the presence of the beatific vision of God. And that's the way that we put it as human beings, for we cannot conceive of what God is. We know that he's a perfect spirit. And in so saying, we have defined something that we have no tools to define. We cannot conceive of a perfect spirit, except in terms of our own activities. So therefore, God must be all good, because we believe that those among us who are the best of our example of human beings are good. He must be all-knowing, for we believe that those among us who are most knowledgeable are of the highest level intellectually. He must be all-just, therefore we see those individuals who reward good works and good activities and punish those that in fact are wrong. And so we put these attributes onto our perfect being. And we conceive of God in our own terms, for there's no other way to do it. For we cannot see those things that are metaphysical or beyond the physical. Those of us who have studied the metaphysical world realize at the point where we are, say, awarded a degree in metaphysics, that we have only scratched the surface of understanding. And we've done it with the weakness of our own human abilities. This is the position of the apostles. They were given to believe that Jesus Christ was the Messiah and would lead them into a triumphant existence as their glorious leader on earth. So their hopes were dashed when he was crucified, when he was taken from them physically. So gathering together after his death, they must have been a huddled mass of absolute confusion and sorrow and doubt. And that's the essence of our lesson today, that doubt. How could we have followed Jesus, they must have thought, for 3 years and believed that he was the Son of God only to see him taken from us and crucified and die. This is something that they were loath to understand as human beings, certainly first century human beings, without any concept of our scientific knowledge in modern times. Those days must have been filled with languishing in doubt. So our story of Thomas is quite understandable. But we are not given only to have faith, for we have been given the ability to learn, and we have been given the ability to understand things from a scientific or empirical basis. So our blessed Lord did not want Thomas simply to believe on faith. He said, come, put your hands into my wounds and accept what you see as reality. For some of them may not have even believed that Jesus was physically present. That's why we read in the scripture that he took food with them and he drank with them. And in today's lesson, they were able to touch him. Those were empirical things that they did, scientific things. Touch is a scientific aspect of our world. When we touch something, we understand it from our feeling of touch. Like when we hear things and we say, well, we understand what we're hearing and what we're listening to. And when we see things or when we taste things, those are empirical senses. And so we are not given to ignore empirical senses in favor of faith. For when we have the evidence, we therefore can appreciate it and believe. So therefore, our scientific community that has developed today over 20-some centuries since Jesus' life has come up with wonderful discoveries about the physical world. But we still have nothing as far as understanding the metaphysical world. This is where our faith comes to play. And so that's why Jesus' words, blessed are they who believe, who have not seen, are so important. For he is demonstrably showing that faith is a power beyond our physical senses. And so blessed are you who believe on the basis of your faith. That is, in fact, why we celebrate the holy sacrifice of the Mass. That we are in fact imbued with the faith that Jesus Christ was our Savior and still is our Savior. He is alive in our world. Much the same as those who have predeceased us are alive in our memory. Jesus is alive in our memory, in our faith. God love you all. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us take a moment now and proclaim our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Begotten, not made, one in being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son he has worshipped and glorified, he has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sin. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Well, let us take a moment now and bring our intentions before God. As people who have seen and those who have not seen and yet believe, we turn in prayer to the God of life. For Christians everywhere, that like Thomas, they may acknowledge Jesus as their Lord and God, and show by their lives that their faith is real. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For government leaders, that they may have more faith and trust in one another, and so spread understanding among people. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who right now are finding it hard to believe, let us pray to the Lord. For those who are grieving the loss of a loved one, that the Lord may console them and restore them to full fellowship with their friends and the community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for one another, that we may be able to see Christ in the signs that he left us, giving us life in baptism, forgiving us in the sacrament of reconciliation, and nourishing us in the Holy Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our own personal intentions, and we hold in the quiet of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, through the resurrection of your Son, you have kindled in our hearts the hope of eternal life. Guard this hope with your grace, and bring it to fulfillment in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. May the mystery of the mingling of this water and wine help us share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. I will wash my hands among the innocent and encompass your altar, O Lord, that I might hear the voice of your praise and tell of all your wondrous works. Have loved, O Lord, the beauty of your house, the place where your glory dwells. Take not away, O Lord, my hope with sin, with men's blood, but rather allow me to worship you in the church. May Almighty God wash away my guilt and cleanse me of my sin. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice would be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and that of all his church. Lord God, through faith and baptism, we have become a new creation, Accept the offerings of your people and bring us to eternal happiness. Grant this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
We give him thanks and praise.
Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. We praise you with greater joy than ever in this Easter season when Christ became our paschal sacrifice. He has made us children of the light, rising anew in everlasting life. He has opened the gates of heaven to receive his faithful people. His death is our ransom from death. His resurrection is our rising to life. The joy in resurrection renews the whole world, while the choirs of heaven sing forever to your glory. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, pleni sunt caeli et terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis. Father, we acknowledge your greatness. All your actions show your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own likeness and set us over the whole world to serve you, our Creator, and rule over all creatures. Even when we disobeyed you and lost your friendship, you did not abandon us to the power of death, but helped us all to seek and find you. Again and again you offer us the covenant and, through the prophets, taught us to hope for salvation. Father, you so loved the world that in the fullness of time you sent your only Son to be our Savior. He was conceived through the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, a man like us in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to those in sorrow joy. In fulfillment of your will he gave himself up to death, but by rising from the dead he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves but for him, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as his first gift to those who believe, to complete his work on earth and bring us the fullness of grace. Father, may this Holy Spirit sanctify these offerings, that they become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, as we celebrate the great mystery which he left us as an everlasting covenant. He always loved those who were his own in this world, and when the time came for him to be glorified by you as Heavenly Father, he showed the depth of his love. While there was supper, he took bread into his sacred hands, and looking up to you as Heavenly Father, he gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup filled with wine. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink of it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. Father, we now celebrate this memorial of our redemption. We recall Christ's death, his descent among the dead, his resurrection, and his ascension to your right hand. And looking forward to his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the acceptable sacrifice which brings salvation to the whole world. Lord, look upon this sacrifice you have given to your church, and by your Holy Spirit, gather all who share this one bread and one cup into the mystical body of Christ, a living sacrifice of praise. Lord, remember those for whom we offer this holy sacrifice, especially our religious leaders and patriarchs. Zurus, our patriarch in Utrecht, Francis, Bishop of Rome, for me, your humble servant, and for bishops and clergy everywhere. Remember those who take part in this offering, those here present and all your people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember those who have died in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith is known to you alone. Father, in your mercy, grant also to us, your children, to enter into our heavenly inheritance in the company of the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and your apostles and saints. Then in your kingdom, freed from the corruption of sin and death, we shall sing your glory with every creature through Christ our Lord, through whom you give us everything that is good. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Well, let us stand now and pray to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and shelter from all needless anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but the faith of our church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
May the mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to those who receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me be parted from you. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Corpus Domini Nostri Jesu Christi custodiat anima meam, in vitam aeternam. Amen. Sanguis Domini Nostri Jesu Christi custodiat anima meam, in vitam aeternam. Amen. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, renewed to everlasting life. Amen. May the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ renewed to everlasting life. Amen. Jesus spoke to Thomas, "Put your hand here and see the place of the nails. Doubt no longer, but believe. Alleluia." The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. Through the resurrection of his Holy Son, God has redeemed you and made you his children. May he bless you with joy. The Redeemer has given you lasting freedom. May you inherit his everlasting life. By faith you rose with him in baptism. May your lives be holy, that you will be united with him forever. And may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Eucharistic celebration is ended for today. Let's go forth from this place to serve the Lord and one another. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Our closing hymn today, Alleluia, Alleluia, hearts to heaven and voices raise.
Alleluia, Alleluia, hearts to heaven and voices raise. Sing to God a hymn of gladness, sing to God a hymn of praise. He who on the cross a victim for the world's salvation bled, Jesus Christ, the King of glory, now is risen from the dead. Now the iron bars are broken, Christ from death to life is born. Glorious life and life immortal on the holy Easter morn. Christ has triumphed and we conquer by his mighty enterprise. We with him to life eternal by his resurrection rise. Christ is risen, Christ the first fruits of the holy harvest field, which will all its full abundance at his sacred coming yield, that the golden doors of harvest will their heads before him rise, ripened by his glorious sunshine from the furrows of the grove. Christ is risen, we are risen, shed upon us heavenly grace, rain and dew and gleams of glory from the brightness of thy face, that we with our hearts in heaven here on earth may fruitful be, and by angel hands be gathered, and be ever, Lord, with thee.
God love you all, and thank you so much for being with us today.